We can fix the housing crisis with a super profits tax.
It's a simple idea. Tax the rich to house all. Likely to annoy the wealthy.
The reform I've outlined today could end homelessness in Australia. I know we're not used to thinking about this big anymore. But there is such a strong appetite out there for an idea like this one.
A union commissioned report says we need more than 750,000 new homes right now, with demand expected to hit almost 1 million by 2041. And it'll take $511 billion to close the housing gap.
The money exists. The wealth exists. But it doesn't exist in ordinary Australian households. It exists in the profit columns of a very small and very elite group of corporations. And we just have to funnel just a portion of it in the right direction.
They propose a permanent 40% tax on the excess profits of companies with an annual turnover upwards of $100 million.
For 99.7% of Australian businesses, this will never be an issue.
That money will go into building 53,000 new social and affordable homes each year to make up the shortfall.
It's about time that, you know, we've got some money from the multinationals.
I'm all for, like, higher taxes for richer people. I think that makes sense. If you have more money, you should pay more.
It's not the way that budgets and the economy actually work to directly tax one party to pay for something completely unrelated.
Business groups say this Robin Hood-style strategy will spell disaster for the economy. Jennifer Westacott warning, we cannot risk penalising the very industries that are doing the heavy lifting in creating jobs, delivering world-class exports and increased revenue for governments.
There's no doubt that people are doing it tough in the rental market, but no, the government has no plans that I'm aware of to have any sort of super tax.
Unless things change, what does the future look like for our kids? For us.
Zach Smith is the National Secretary of the CFMEU. Zach, Kevin Rudd and Julia Gillard tried and failed to bring in a super profits tax. Do you think Anthony Albanese will be more successful?
Look, I do see the readiness to act on this issue, and I hope that all our political leaders have the courage to act on this issue. I get around this country, I talk to people in different states and territories all across the country, and this issue rates right at the top of concerns that ordinary Australians have. They know there's something not quite right in our economic system, where they're being punished month after month with interest rate increases and being told to show wage restraint on the one hand, whilst on the other hand, we're seeing a very small elite segment of corporate Australia record super profits, see CEOs celebrate double, you know, sometimes bonuses and pay increases is double the inflation rate. And so these two things don't align. And so I think there's a real political moment here where people have had enough.
You want this to apply to excess profits, and that would, I gather, depending on how you want to define it, capture only a small number of companies. But which companies do you really mean? Like, can you be specific about the companies you would actually go after here?
We are not looking just at the mining sector. We are looking at any company that posts a super profit and there being a 40% tax rate applied just to that excess profit. So that would include the big banks who just have recorded $17.1 billion in profit while we're still debating a $10 billion Housing Australia Future Fund. That would include the big supermarkets, the duopoly, who have increased their profit margins over the COVID pandemic while the rest of us were doing it tough. That would include Qantas, who similarly has doubled their profit margins over the period of the COVID pandemic.
But for these kind of companies that you're going after, won't they just find a loophole and ship all these profits offshore?
That is a problem you have with any taxation system. I actually have complete faith in Treasury and the ATO that we can design a system which isn't easily able to be evaded. I mean,
well like the
tax
mining
evasion
tax
is an issue
for
corporate
that,
taxes,
that
income
raised
tax.
$0?
Yeah, well, look, the difference with the mining tax, if you're talking about the tax that was proposed by Kevin Rudd a number of years ago, is that, you know, it wasn't linked to something such as this massive housing crisis that we've got, that we're facing as a nation right now. And I think it's important to come back to what are we trying to fix with this tax?
But the question really is whether this one would or could succeed
Because if we've seen multinational companies do this a lot, right? They will rearrange their affairs, they will pay as little tax as possible because they will make sure they're headquartered or their profit is declared in countries with low tax rates. You whack a super profits tax on, at worst, they take their business elsewhere, but even if they don't, they just take their profits elsewhere. How can you be so confident there's a way around that?
There is ways of capturing. We do it currently with our own corporate taxation arrangements. These are not problems that we haven't thought of before as a country. And, you know, I do note that the current government has done a lot to close the loopholes in this respect too, and they're proposing to do more. So it's not fair to say that, companies will just get around tax laws, because that could happen with our existing corporate taxation arrangements. And yet it doesn't. It does happen in small pockets, and those loopholes are getting closed. But it's not enough just to say, oh, OK, there might be a way, a hypothetical way, that a company evades it. So, therefore, let's just dismiss the idea out of hand. It's not sufficient to say that. And at the end of the day, the question you come back to is, how do we raise the money we need to invest in housing whilst causing the least amount of harm to the majority of Australians? And the answer to us is very clear. It's a super profits tax. And that is also underscored by the independent economic research that we commissioned Oxford Economics Australia to produce, which was launched today as part of our campaign, and which also says a well-calibrated, well-understood super profits tax could work. It could work, and more than that, it would raise the money needed to invest in social and affordable housing and ultimately deliver the housing that we need as a country to put a roof over every Australian's head.
OK, Zach, thank you so much for joining us this evening. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
How interesting to hear somebody with an ideology speak about rather than the two main political parties who are too scared to support such a notion, because when they leave politics, they want to be on the boards of those companies, so they're not upsetting them. And to hear someone who's got an idea...
Well, Labor had a similar idea, though, just with the mining sector.
Yeah, now they're in a position to affect it.
Well, no, when they were, that yes. and it fell over. That was
But now I think the climate in the country is very different.
Right, yeah.
People know they're just getting an absolute walloping at every point, and I think the appetite is there to see major companies who have fleets of lawyers to help them pay the minimum tax, to actually pay to participate in profit-making in this country.
If you can make them, that's...
Yeah, if you can make them.
Yeah.